Hi everyone, I'm Shriram Sankaran, Senior Product Manager at Syncfusion. So we all face those moments, right, where we have a clear vision of what we want to build. Then comes the real challenge of picking the right components, configuring their properties and fine-tuning them. I can see a few heads nodding in acceptance. So it's not rocket science, but it does take some time away from what could be used for solving more important and interesting problems in our applications. Also, creating a functional product from a single natural description prompt is no mean feat. So developers on a daily basis face challenges while creating a product from prompts. So in this session, I'll just share my experience of building SyncGen UI, an MCP server that can be easily integrated with tools like GitHub Copilot. So this multi-agent system is powered by AutoGen that transforms natural language descriptions and image inputs into functional HTML and JavaScript code. So the agents that I just discussed, what it does is that it validates the input prompts, converts them into layouts, and finally generates the UI code. While this solution, it can be like adapted to use with your preferred framework and UI components, I'll be using Syncfusion JavaScript controls for this particular demo. So before we go into the demo, I'll just show you two key projects involved in this particular solution. So the first one is a model context protocol that is TypeScript based. So the client enables transport via STDIO, processes the user queries and images, and then communicates with the backend server for UI generation. This server is a Python fast API service that leverages AutoGen to orchestrate LLM interactions, and then it takes care of processing the text inputs and the images for UI code generation. So the multi-agent workflow that we'll be discussing in a few moments exists in this particular server. And Anthropic's Claude is used as the LLM. So it's time for demo. I'll just call the tool over here. As you can see, GitHub Copilot is open in VS Code, and we have the backend server and the MCP server deployed locally and is up and running. For ease of access, I have the prompt to be used for this particular demo in a file under the prompts folder. I'll just open that. So there you go. I'll copy this and I'll just call the tool. So as the tool is named SyncGen UI, I'll say, hey, SyncGen UI, have this prompt. So what it tells is that build a basic calculator with the respective technologies that performs the basic calculation operations with the necessary buttons. So we will just run this. It must just start the tool in a few moments. Yeah, I'll just continue. So typically the UI generation takes about a minute or two, depending on the complexity of the request. So in the meantime, we'll just have a look at how the multi-agent workflow works and how these agents collaborate with each other to generate the final output. So for that, we will just go back to the slide for an illustration. So as you can see, the architecture utilizes four specialized agents with distinct responsibilities. So first we have the input validator agent, the layout generator agent, image reader, and the UI code generator agents. So typically, this particular tool accepts both text and image prompts. If the prompt is text, it passes to the input validator agent, which evaluates whether the request is related to UI generation or not. If it is related to UI generation, it then passes to the layout generator agent, which generates the structured JSON layouts. If it is not related to UI generation, what happens is that the agent terminates the process. For images, the system, it easily adapts to use the image reader agent, which extracts UI details directly from the provided image. And both these structured JSON layouts from the layout generator and the image reader passes to the UI code generator in either case, where the functional HTML and JavaScript code is generated. So as you can see, instead of using a single agent for all these processes, we have split the process into four steps, and each agent is assigned to these steps. So based on how refined your prompt is, the process of prompt to product would be accurate since this passes through four phases. Let's go back to the demo. I believe the tool has run successfully. Yes, it has. So this output is available under the outputs folder for ease of access. So I'll just open that. Okay, so this is the UI code generator. As you can see over here, this starts with Syncfusion's necessary references for script and styles, but this is not the actual output generated by the UI code gen agent. The actual output generated by the UI code gen agent is available in the body of this particular HTML file, and the head section has been added as part of the workflow after the output is generated by these agents. So as you can see, the layout is generated using SyncFusion JavaScript controls, followed by which we have the event handling logic. So we will just launch this file in a browser. I'll just open this in File Explorer, and then, yeah. There you go. So we got the UI of a basic calculator. Let's see whether it's functional. And yes, it is. So it's always exciting to see live demo in action, right? And just think about the time that this saves. So next, what we can look at is how this multi-agent workflow is implemented in the server project from a coding point of view. For that, I'll just open the agents file. Yeah, as you can see over here, each agent is created using AutoGen's assistant agent class, which defines the agent's name, the model client, and its role and its responsibilities. Also, each agent is specialized with tailored system prompts, as you can see over here. So for example, let's take a look at a couple of agent prompts. For that, I'll just navigate to the agent's prompt file. Okay, so this particular prompt, that is the input validation prompt, is used by the input validator agent. So what this prompt tells the agent is that, please act as an intent classifier such that you need to classify the input, whether it's related or irrelevant. That is whether it's related to UI generation or not. And it also tells to respond only in this particular JSON format. That is, it must have a category and the reasoning. So that's how this prompt works. And next we have the layout prompt. So this prompt is used by the layout generator agent, that is for generating layout from text prompts, not for image, for text prompts. So as you can see, this prompt tells the AI agent to analyze the UI specifications and generate structured JSON layouts. As you can see, it provides comprehensive guidelines for control selection, responsive design, and styling of the output so that it ensures that all necessary information is available in the output to be used as a complete functional UI. The core functionality of this system is available in the chat file. And this function, what it does is that it accepts both text and image prompts, as you can see over here. The prompt that we just provided for the demo is a related text prompt. That is, it's related to UI generation. So in that case, what happens is that the prompt passes to the input validator agent, which classifies it as related and sends it to the layout generator agent, as you can see over here. So this is the part that will be executed since this is not an image. So the prompt goes as a user prompt to the layout generator agent, which generates a structured JSON layout. And then once it is like generated, the most important process happens, which is the control extraction. So in this process, all controls that are like available in the JSON layout are mapped with SyncFusion control names that's like available as metadata in this particular system. So this metadata is nothing but HTML elements and JavaScript initialization code that's required for the SyncFusion controls basic rendering. Once that is done, we just move on to the UI code gen agent, where the user prompt is provided with the initial user request, the layout strategy from the layout agent, that is the layout generator agent, and the control references from the control extraction process. So in this way, as you can see, each agent communicates with one another in a sequential manner within a well-defined pipeline. So the UI code gen agent finally generates the production-ready HTML and JavaScript code. So this is with respect to the processing of text prompts. So let's see how the input validator agent works in action. So I'll just call SyncGen UI and I'll wantedly ask a question that's not related to UI generation. So I will tell, how do I process or how do I optimize database queries? So I'll just run it. So this must run quickly since the agent would throw away, that is, it would like stop the process or terminate it. So there you go. So what it tells is that the input is specifically about database query optimization and it's not related to me. So that is what the input validator agent does over here. So next, what we can look at is we can provide a different input to this particular tool, that is images, and see how the tool functions. For that, I'll just open the image that will be provided as the input. So this is the image that I'm going to provide to the tool. So this is a simple login page. I will copy the path. Okay. So I'll just call the tool again, and I'll paste this image. And I will ask it to generate UI based on the image provided. Okay, the image has been pasted over here. Let's run the tool. I'll just start this. Since the prompt that I've provided is an image input, the process starts with the image reader agent over here. So the user's text prompt and the image is sent as a multimodal message to the image reader agent, where it extracts the UI details and converts them into structured JSON layouts. So this JSON layout then comes into the control extraction process similar to the text prompts, and then finally to the UI code gen agent, where we construct the user prompt using the previous steps context too, where you have the user query, the image analysis from the image reader agent, and the control references from the control extraction process, and finally the Base64 image. So this is how the process happens for an image input. While that's running, let's quickly take a look at how the MCP server is architected and deployed. So for that, I will just navigate to the MCP project. That will open the index.ts file. So as you can see over here, the MCP server is configured by creating an instance, and then the SyncFusion Gen UI tool is like registered over here. The details regarding the SyncGen UI tool is available in a separate file where you have the necessary details for that particular tool, which is name, description, input schema, and finally the handler. So this handler handles the text and image inputs that we provide in GitHub Copilot. So if the input consists of an image, we first resolve it into Base64, and then the text and the image data is passed to the backend API. So once that process completes successfully, the response is formatted to a structured JSON that's required by the MCP server. So this is how the MCP server is architected. With respect to deployment, we just need to navigate to the settings section of VS Code and search for MCP, and navigate to settings.json. So this is the code snippet that is required for deploying this MCP server. So what we need to do is we need to provide the details regarding the MCP server, which is the command that is node, since the node compiler is going to process the file for which the path has been provided in the argument section. So which is the index.js built from the index.ts file. So pretty straightforward, right? So that completes the MCP server architecture and deployment. So we'll just jump back to the demo. I believe the tool has run successfully. Yes, it has. You have the output over here. So for that, I'll just navigate back to the outputs folder and then open it. So there you go. So this is the output that we expected from the image that was like provided as input to this particular tool. So that pretty much wraps up the demo that I like planned for today. For this particular demo, I had like used SyncGen UI to generate simple UI. But in general, it can generate more complex interfaces like e-product commerce pages and dashboards too. And with respect to whom this particular solution will be useful, it will be useful for front-end developers, since this particular approach significantly reduces development time. And for teams who already use GitHub Copilot and want to enhance their productivity using specialized capabilities. So as I already informed, this solution can be adapted to use your favorite or preferred UI frameworks or components by just modifying the system prompts and then the controls metadata along with adding the necessary references. So it's that simple. So with that, we have come to the end of this session. Thank you all for joining.